Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.0.1 and iOS 15.3 Beta 1 have been out for about a week or so, or a few days, depending on which version you're running. And so I wanted to talk about the overall experience based off my use on the iPhone 13 Pro, 13 Pro Max, and my iPad Pro, as well as your experience based off the YouTube community poll. Currently, there's over 26,000 votes at the time of this video with 390 comments. And I use those comments to give you the best picture overall of what the update is like to use and any existing bugs or what's great about it. Now, the first thing is this past week, Apple released an AirPods firmware update. If you weren't familiar with this, I did a separate video on it. I also have a separate video on how to update the AirPods since it's not straightforward. And hopefully Apple will fix this in the future by giving us a software update button. But with AirPods, AirPods Pro and AirPods Max, AirPods 2, and even older AirPods are having the update. 4A400 is the update number. And with AirPods Pro, you get Conversation Boost, and you also get Find My with the Pro and Max AirPods. So you can find them in Find My, similar to finding an AirTag. So that's something they updated. If you haven't updated it yet, I would encourage you to update them, as it could have other bug fixes as well, but Apple hasn't specifically mentioned that. Now, as far as overall stability, iOS 15.0.1 and 15.1 Beta 3 seem to be very hit or miss depending on who you ask. There is a huge amount of people saying that iOS 15.0.1 is a huge increase in stability and bug fixes compared to iOS 15, but then there's some other people saying that it's terrible, has terrible battery life, issues with standby. In fact, one person in the community poll said that they had it on standby, put it next to their bed, and went from 90% to zero overnight and then missed their alarm. And so something was using power in the background when this was happening. Now, I typically plug it in to make sure things like that don't happen and then just let optimized battery charging deal with the battery, but you still shouldn't have a 90% battery drain overnight. So there's definitely some issues still. Now, with iOS 15.0.1, quite a few people are saying that it is stable though, and it's not causing too many issues. Now, there is some freezing from time to time. This is an iPhone 7, and you can see how it's performing. It has iOS 15.0.1 on it, and it seems to be okay for the most part. I haven't really had too many issues, but the battery does drain quickly, but the battery may need to be replaced in this device. Now, for some though, on the iPhone 7, it's freezing up and things like that. So you'll see here, it's a little bit choppy when scrolling, but it is loading everything in the background. Once it loads, it will be complete and work fine. It really depends on what device you have, maybe settings you've had in the past. And one thing I've said a few different times that fixed a bunch of issues for me was resetting your settings. And you can do that by going to your settings, then going to general, then going down to transfer or reset iPhone, reset, and then reset all settings. Now, I don't recommend this for most people. It will not wipe the phone, but it will take all of your settings such as Wi-Fi, any location settings, any battery optimizations you've done, and reset them back to normal. And then you'll have to start over. So that's a bit of a pain. So I don't recommend that unless you're having a lot of issues, but it won't wipe the phone. You'll still have all of your data and everything, but it does seem to be a problem for some. Now, there are issues that are still remaining on both phones, and both are still having issues with CarPlay, whether that be in a specific type of car or not. Some people are having it freeze. Music presents a problem with freezing. Sometimes it just doesn't work well and freezes and locks up in CarPlay. And sometimes even on the phone as well, it will stop playing and crash for some. So that's something that's there in both. CarPlay seems to be a mess with iOS 15 and needs some additional work. Hopefully that's resolved by the time iOS 15.1 is released. Now, also the touch bug that a lot of people were having seems to be resolved. So where you would touch and it just wouldn't respond, it's resolved with the exception of YouTube. With YouTube, sometimes it still is there. When I scroll, I'll have to touch on the video a couple times. Then I can scroll up and down and then tap it and it works. So there's something with the YouTube app specifically. I haven't experienced that in any other app. So hopefully we'll have an update for that soon. The storage bug is still there for many people as well. Now, there's two different versions of the storage bug. Some people are just seeing more storage than their phone actually offers in their settings, and other, under general and then iPhone storage, are seeing huge amounts of storage taken up. So there's some discrepancies in this. Some people will say they have a 256 gigabyte iPhone like this, and it will show 300 gigabytes available. So there's something going on that's causing this issue. What it is specifically, we don't know. I thought it was 100% resolved in the last public update, but it seems that it's not. You'll see my system data is there. Everything seems to be okay on this phone. But again, it seems to be those with some odd settings or something going on in the background. Also, a few other people are saying that widgets are not updating properly. So the widgets could show, well, it's so 73 degrees and cloudy. Some people will show that it's got thunderstorms locally. You go into the app itself and it's not updated the widget because it's raining out. So there's different situations that people are in, whether that be in where I'm living or somewhere else. It just seems to be something that's odd from time to time where it just doesn't update properly. So hopefully they fix that in a future update very soon. Now, also notifications seem to be a problem for some. They're just not coming in properly, or they're just not making a noise in certain apps for some people. I've heard this from multiple people, and there's also comments about it as well, but that is still an issue for some people. So all of those bugs still exist, as well as the call hangup bug. However, Apple specifically mentioned this for the beta. So if you're on a phone call using your phone app, sometimes it can just hang up and you'll have to try it again or restart your phone. This is a known bug in the notes. So Apple's already aware of it and working on it. Hopefully that's resolved again with either a future update or by the time 15.1 is released to the public. Now, performance seems to be okay overall. Now, on older devices with 15.0.1, performance seems to be okay. It is a little bit sluggish from time to time. You'll see right now scrolling is okay. On the iPhone 7, if I go back into music, it's loaded now, but it's a little stuttery as I scroll through. I don't think this is a limitation of this update per se. It could be the phone being a little bit older, and it does seem to be getting a little bit warm. At least the iPhone 7 is quite warm right now. Not all of my phones do this, just the iPhone 7 for some reason. So I'm experiencing it on this device where it's seemingly overly warm and the battery's dropping rapidly because it's processing something heavily in the background. So that typically happens when it's warm, it's processing usually, and the processor's getting warm and doing some heavy tasks in the background. What specifically, we don't really know. There's something going on. Again, like I said, some people are seeing excessive drain just on standby. Now, if we take a look at the battery life on my 13 Pro over the past week or so, you'll see battery health is at 100%, as you would expect with a new phone. And we'll take a look at yesterday, and I had 3 hours and 49 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 57 minutes of screen off time, and used between 50 and 60% or so. And so that's pretty good. If you maybe double that or add an additional 40%, I'm getting the 6 to 7 hours of screen on time I would expect with this device, with maybe 7 or 8 hours of screen off time as well. Battery is great on the iPhone 13 Pro, and regardless of what version I've been on, it seems to be the same, whether that be 15.0.1 or 15.1 Beta 3. Both seem to be doing okay for me. So that's not an issue for me. Some people are seeing different battery life. And on the 13 Pro Max, again, when I was using this full time, I've been switching due to reviews and things, but when I was using this full time, you'll see a week or so ago, I had the day before, I had 5 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 46 minutes of screen off time, and used about 60 to 70% of the battery. So again, this is an amazing phone for battery life. And even on betas and things, it seems to be performing well. Now, that doesn't mean everybody's going to have the same experience. We're all using different apps. We have different settings, so it can make a difference. Now, on iPadOS 15.1 Beta 3, I've had a similar experience. The overall beta is good. I've had good stability on this iPad Pro, but the battery life has been terrible for me on this device. For some reason, I can't get over about 5 or 6 hours of screen on time. And so let's go to the last 10 days. You'll see I charged it a day ago, and I've had 3 hours and 18 minutes of screen on time, 9 hours and 43 minutes of screen off time. I don't use this with the screen off. I don't use it for music or anything else. And it shows that YouTube, Safari, and Mail, those are what I use normally when I'm using the iPad. For some reason, there's a lot of background usage. So I'm only getting about 5 hours of screen on time, but huge amounts of screen off time, which doesn't make any sense. Maybe it's Telegram, but it's only 1%. It doesn't make any sense because I'm not using this with the screen off. So there's definitely something odd going on with the beta update on my iPad. And of course, you'll want to report any of that and feedback. Now that leads me to, should you update to iOS 15.0.1 or 15.1 Beta 3? Well, if you're on iOS 15, I would recommend going to 15.0.1 just due to security and bug fixes. But if you're wondering if you should go to the beta, I would probably hold off until the public release. iOS 15.1 probably will be out sooner rather than later. later. Apple just stopped signing the other day. iOS 15, meaning you can no longer downgrade to it, which means usually within a couple of weeks we'll have a public release. Now, one thing they did add with 15.1 Beta 3 is new images for Apple Watch Series 7, which comes out on the 15th. It'd be really odd or different for Apple to release it before the 15th, but it wouldn't surprise me if they did, since they're already putting different images and things for new products in there. I could be wrong, but we could see an update that soon, or we could see it in a couple weeks. However, if we don't see the final this week, I would expect a release candidate or possibly another beta. But at this point, I'm thinking they're going to push it out more quickly unless they do something in between with 15.0.2. We just don't know at this point. Apple has been very random these days, and they're not following what they did with last year or the year before. So we'll have to wait and see with that. We're also expecting some invites soon for an October Apple event, where they're expected to introduce M1X MacBooks and maybe some new AirPods 3 as well. So we could see that very soon, as soon as this week, and maybe we'll have another week of updates and product releases. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll and comments, let's take a look at those. Let's refresh here. And you'll see at the time of this video, there's 27,000 votes now. So 1,000 since I started recording this video. So I really appreciate it. 74% of you are on iOS 15.0.1. Only 11% are on beta 3. 6% are on iOS 14.8 or older. 1% still on 13.7 or older, and 7% are using Android. So thanks again for voting. And again, this is where I get all of the information for these videos. Let's take a look at some of these comments, maybe 5 or 10 of them. So you'll see John says 15.0.1 has its share of glitches on my iPhone 10. My biggest complaint is the podcast app, which I use daily, has been trashed. It regularly forgets my lineup of shows and won't pick up where I left off. Extremely annoying. Waldo Guzman says all was fine with my iPhone 12 Pro Max with iOS 15 until I installed 15.0.1. My phone is overheating and low signal, which is strange because I had good signal in this area. You may want to try and reset those settings or go into about and see if you have a cellular update as well. Sometimes you'll have that also. Will A says I have iPhone XR using iOS 15.1 beta 3 and no problems at all. Florida Clay said, using on iPhone 13 Pro Max, battery charge life is much, much better than my old 11 Pro Max. Getting 2 days of charge, I do turn it off at night though. Mike Fleming says, have an iPhone XR 15.0.1. Battery life is certainly not as good as it was on 14.8, and the phone heats up a lot more when watching videos. More than it used to, anyway. MMagic13 says, I only have my iPhone 11 for 1 year, and the battery life isn't as good as it used to be before the iOS 15 and 15.0.1 update. The phone still works amazing, but the battery life is my only problem, even though I still have 95% maximum battery capacity, and my iPhone gets very warm after average use for some reason after the iOS 15 update and later. Jakara says, I'm using an iPhone 11. It's stable and battery is doing great, but there's a small bug on the back arrow when sometimes it disappears on Safari. You need to refresh so that it can appear again. A long existing bug is on shortcuts notifications, where if I restart my device, it comes on by default, even if it was off. Gaurav Tandon says, I'm on iOS 15.0.1 on iPhone 13 Pro, and it's working fine, but sometimes music doesn't play. I need to click the play button multiple times or need to close the app altogether and then reopen, and then it works fine. I hope this gets fixed. Joe Pham says, I used to have a bug with AirPods Pro not being able to switch back to noise cancellation mode on iOS 15. 15.0.1 seems to have fixed it, and good battery too on my 12 mini. Brad16 says, I've been using the latest beta for a while. Today I had to wipe it off my 12 mini. Battery drained 90% overnight. Daniel says, I'm on 15.0.1 using an iPhone 7 Plus. Battery is great, but I still have the storage bug. It's showing incorrect available storage. Tampa says, using 15.0.1 on iPhone XR, good battery life for me. So that's it for iOS 15.0.1 and iOS 15.1 beta 3. Hopefully we see iOS 15.1 very soon. And I'd love to hear from you also if you're using these updates and they've gotten any better or maybe even worse over the past few days since you may have commented on that poll or that you've been using them. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.